Hello, dear friends. You and Humphreys here. I appreciate you tuning in on me. I want to speak a few minutes, just about a 10-minute message on the 23rd Psalm, one of the great psalms in the Bible, one of the great scriptures in the Bible. David wrote the 23rd Psalm, and it's a great portion of scripture. And then I just want to take a few minutes. I want to speak on the first two verses, and then maybe another sermon, message, at least maybe two more messages on this wonderful 23rd Psalm. But first, I want to speak to you on these two verses. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. Praise the Lord and leads me in paths of righteousness. I want us to think a moment, and may the Lord bless these few words to your heart. The Lord is my shepherd. God looks upon us as sheep. The Bible often describes His people as sheep. Now sheep are, first of all, they are a very weak animal. And all of us are weak as far as determining our future and what we can do and what we cannot do. But the sheep are very, very much in need of help. They're prone to wander off and get lost. And so it is with us. We're prone to wander off in the wrong way and make wrong decisions until we find out that we are really in trouble and facing trials that we cannot seem to understand or ever be able to get through. And so it is with God's people. We need a shepherd to guide us. A shepherd would do two or three things. Number one, he would guide his sheep. And the Lord God will guide you. The Bible says He will be your guide even unto death. And we need to be guided by all things. And in regard to the fact that you are a Christian and that you love the Lord and you believe in Jesus Christ, then you become a child of God. And as His child, He will lead you. Excuse me. And He will guide you into all truth. And Jesus said, I'll send you the Holy Spirit, and He will guide you into all that you need to do and go. He will guide you wherever you need to go. I want you to know right now, dear friend, God will guide you. He will guide you as a shepherd guides his sheep. The shepherd led his sheep into places where they could find green pastures and where they could find water. And so the Lord's leading you right now. He's going to give you a place of green pastures, plentiful blessings, and manifold goodness of God. Things are going to work out for you if you keep trusting Jesus. Keep calling on the name of the Lord. Keep believing in your God. Keep endeavoring to please Him as best you can. Forgiving others, reading your Bible, going to church when you can, and worshiping Him. And so it is as you seek to let Him guide you. He will direct you and guide you as a shepherd guides his sheep. He loves you very much. He loves you very much. He gives you things that you can never have without Him. For instance, in John, in the 15th chapter of John, the 10th chapter of John, we read these words in verse 11. Jesus said, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. So Jesus is the good shepherd. He is your shepherd. He wants to bless you and guide you and direct you and provide for your needs. And now we recognize something, that He laid down His life for you. He went to that cross and died, suffered, paid the price, and there He rose from the grave. He lives today and He's coming back. You need to trust Him and love Him, and how important it is to know that you can do that, and He wants you to do it. And I am asking you right now to pray, if you've never prayed before, asking Him to forgive you and come in your heart. Just say, dear God, please forgive me. I believe in Jesus. I believe He died for me and paid for all my sins. I believe He rose again from the grave. And I believe He's coming back. Come in my heart, Lord Jesus, and help me live for You. Amen and amen. Pray a prayer like that, and you shall live forever. And the Lord God will be your shepherd. Again, over in verse 10 and verse 14, he said, I'm the good shepherd, and I know my sheep, and they know me. Jesus knows you. He knows you, dear Christian friend. He knows you by name. He knows everything you've gone through and what you're going through right now. And he knows what you're going to have to go through in the future. And he said, don't you worry. I'm going to be with you. I am the same yesterday, today, and forever. His love never changes. He's with you until the morning. Stay with him through the darkness of the night. The morning comes and God will bless. Let the Lord be your strength today. Look to him as the good shepherd. The little sheep depending on the shepherd. Learn to depend upon your Lord and depend upon your God. He will bless you. Oh, praise the Lord. He will lead you and he will guide you in green pastures and still waters. He will protect you. Now, not only did the shepherd guide his sheep, he protected them. He protected them from animals, wild animals, and from predators and from thieves that would try to steal them. No, he'd protect them. And he had his strong rod with him, and he was able to do that. And so God protects you. He protects you and abides with you. He said in the Word of God in Joshua, the first chapter, he said, fear not, for I'm with you, and I will be with you wherever you go. Fear not, I will be with you. And so he's with you. Do not fear what the devil can do, because he that's in you is greater than he that's in the world. That's what the Bible said. The Lord God is with you, and he protects you, and he keeps you from the evil. Praise the Lord God. Protected by him. And he has protected me many times, many times. I've been protected by the almighty hand of God. I was in a collision here just a few years ago, and I pulled up and stopped, and a big truck came up beside me, and they had some two big tubifores sticking out, and as they went by, those tubifores went right in the back window of my car where I was sitting waiting for the light, and it just changed, and that truck just slowed down, but it kept going, and those tubifores went right into, tore my window. Window pane just tore it all to pieces. And so I pulled over, and the truck pulled over, and the police came, and the man got a ticket, I'm sorry to say, but anyway, I said to the officer, well, you know, I'm lucky that I'm not in the hospital. Those tubifores didn't miss the back of my head that far. And that officer said, friend, you don't know it, but you're lucky you're not in the funeral home. And just about 4 more inches, and I'd have been a dead man. But God protects us. He protects us not only that way, but many ways. He protects us. He protects us from falling, from hurting. He protects us from having to face death at many times and issues of life. The hand of the Lord is upon you, Christian. And he says, don't you worry. I'm the good shepherd, and I'll protect you. I'll protect you. Amen. He makes things work out for your good. I read an interesting, very interesting story of a man named Gilbert Ginsburg, who was a missionary to Europe. And he was a Christian, and he was coming back on furlough to America. And he left, and he got as far as Lisbon, and he was supposed to go on from Lisbon over to England, and on his way to America. And when he got to Lisbon, there was terrible weather. And they said, we cannot get you to leave Lisbon. And he had to stay there for about 4 days. And after 4 days, the storm was over, and they were able to get across the channel, and they went into England. And the man had a ticket on a ship that was to go to America. He missed that ship by 4 days. The name of the ship was the Titanic. Praise God. Saved by the grace of God. The missionary that was going home. We need to see that God can shut doors and open doors. God can do marvelous things. He's the good shepherd. He takes care of us. He loves us. We're going to live as long as He decrees it. And when we time to come, He'll call us home. So be faithful. Be faithful. Be not worried. Trust God. He's your shepherd and He loves you. And He holds you by your hand. And He says, come on, I'm with you. I'm going to guide you into where you need to go. Sometimes it looks like it's the wrong way, but it's always His way, the right way. Let Him guide you and love you and keep you and forgive you and know that He is your shepherd. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. Amen. God bless you in every way and keep you close to Him. Amen and amen.